Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. Were you spying on me while I was meditating? I don't like it when people spy on me. I guess I have to stop meditating and start teaching you English. Okay, so in my last lesson, you'll remember that I taught you the names of different body positions in English, right? Like bow or kneel or some other words I taught you in that lesson. Well, in this lesson, I'm going to teach you a few more words. Okay, so take a look at the way I'm sitting. How would you describe this in English? Which word would you use to describe my legs? Look at the way I'm sitting. Okay, do you know? I'm going to give you 3 seconds. One, two, three. Okay, I'm sitting cross-legged. Cross-legged. Okay, you know, a lot of people in different parts of the world, they sit like this. You know, they don't sit on chairs. Like here in Western culture, people usually sit on chairs in their living room. Well, if you go to some countries like Pakistan, for example, you know, people in their living rooms, very often they don't have chairs. They sit like on a cushion on the floor. Okay, so they sit cross-legged. Cross-legged. Right where your legs are crossed. Now listen to that word, legged. Legged, not legged. There's a little syllable in there. Cross-legged. Cross-legged. Okay, so that's how you describe sitting like this, sitting on the floor. If you meditate, you know, some people, I don't know why this position is so popular when people meditate. I don't even know how to meditate or do yoga. But if you're into that kind of stuff, then you should know this position. It's called sitting cross-legged. Okay. Now which other what about this one, okay? What position am I in right now? Okay? I'm just on my hands and knees, right? Well, we have a word for this position and it's called all fours, right? I'm on all fours, right? One, two, three, four. I'm on all fours. Like animals are usually on all fours. Now, some animals, like bears, they can stand up on their hind legs, right? Hind means back. Their hind legs, their back legs. I don't think they stand up on their front legs. That would be weird. That would be doing a handstand. I don't think bears can do handstands. But yeah, if bears are like, if they're angry or I don't know why, but sometimes bears, they stand up right on their hind legs. And then when they run, they go down on all fours and then they run on all fours. I don't think bears can run on their hind legs. Wouldn't that be funny to see a bear running like this on its that'd be crazy. If you just were driving along the highway and you suddenly look and you see a bear just jogging like this. That'd be great. Okay, so this position is being on all fours. Now, there are a lot of different names for positions in yoga, and I don't know all the names of all those positions. I think in yoga, every position has a special name, right? In yoga, there's all kinds of weird poses. Now, I think most native English speakers don't know the names of all those different poses, but just for a simple pose like this, right, everybody would know that this is all fours, right? If we talk about something or an animal or a human or something on all fours, this is what we mean. Just like this, right? Both hands and both knees are touching. Well, I don't know if it has to be knees. You could, if you were like that, and that would probably be considered all fours too. But I think all fours usually means knees and hands. Okay, so that's the second position. Okay, so sitting cross-legged, and being on all fours. Now, what about this? Now, let's see, can you see? I don't have a lot of space to work here. But take a look at this, right? Can you see me? I hope you can see me. All right, see my head? Like, how would you describe this position? Right, I'm just reclining. This is called a reclined position, right? Reclining means like relaxing. Like maybe you just finished eating a big meal and you're really full and you just want to recline. You just sort of lie down. Like it's not really lying down. Like this would be lying down, right? If you have your whole body on the ground. But with this is like you're reclined. But how would you describe this? How would you describe my head and my arm? Well, I'll tell you. My head is propped up on my hand. Right? It's propped up on my hand. Okay? That means my head is being supported by my arm, right? My hand. It's being propped up. Right? Like right now, my head is not really being propped up. Right now I'm having to use these muscles in my neck. Well, I guess my head is being propped up by my muscles. I don't know, that sounds a bit awkward. Propped up means to be supported, right? So right now my head is propped up. Propped up. Okay? It's a very comfortable position. You know, if you wake up in the middle of the night and you want to check your phone, right? You might see you have a message on your phone. And then you might prop your head up like this on your hand, and you might check your phone messages, right? So this is a very common position that people are in. It's called a reclined position with your head propped up on your hand or propped up by your arm or however you want to say that, okay? So what did we do so far? We learned cross-legged, all fours, and reclined and propped up. There's one more that I wanted to teach you. Remember in my last video, I taught you the word prostrate, to prostrate yourself before a king or before the Pope, right? It means to lie flat, like this, with your face down, right? To lie face down before the king or something like that, okay? That's a prostrated position. You are prostrating yourself before the king. Okay, but one thing I forgot to mention, I was gonna tell you, but I got so carried away talking about the king and the pope. I forgot to sort of mention another word we use to talk about lying flat, face down, and that's the word prone. Prone. A prone position is a flat position face down. Okay, so I'll show you. This is prone, right? I don't know. If I don't think it matters where your hands are. If your hands are like this or something like that, babe. So right now I'm lying prone. I'm in a prone position. Okay, so that's just another word for prostrated, right? If you're in a prostrated position, or a prone position, it's the same. It's where you're lying flat, face down. Okay, so I just wanted to mention that. What other positions? I think that's it for this lesson, but I might be able to think of part three. I'll post the link to part one somewhere up here at the end of this video in case you missed it, but maybe I should try to think of a part three, because there are a lot of different ways to talk about body positions in English, right? It's a very common thing, but it's maybe something you've never really learned about. You know, sitting cross-legged. I mean, you probably do that, or you know people who do that all the time, but maybe you never learned how to describe that in English. Well, that's why I'm making this mini-series to teach you how to describe these kind of body positions in English. So let me know down there if you want me to think of part three in this series. But anyway, hope you guys are having a wonderful day wherever you are, and I'll see you over in the next episode of Mad English TV. Take care.